Hi, in this video we're going to be taking a look at dictionaries again. Dictionaries are a really powerful tool when programming. I think they're really worth getting used to using, and hopefully, having watched a few of my video tutorials, you will have a good idea about how you may use them. I have made video tutorials on dictionaries before, and they do explore how you can sort the content, so I do recommend taking a look at those. They'll be found in my Python Fun Mini Projects section, so do take a look. But for this part of the video, I'm just focusing on printing students who are either true or set to true or set to false. Okay, so let's take a look at how we do that. So I know that I'm going to have to loop through my dictionary, so I'm going to use a for loop. I know that I'm going to use a for loop because I know that my program will detect how long the length of the dictionary is. So for loops are very good for looping when you know how many times you want to loop. You use a while loop when you don't know how many times you want to loop. So I'm going to use a for loop. So for name in my dictionary, I could have called my dictionary, or let's call it something sensible like student list. Okay, so student list, and I'll change this here to student list. Okay, so for name in student list, if student list name, so I'm looking at that key, is equal to true, then I'm going to print the name of the student. Okay, and that is essentially the program. So here, oh, I've got an unexpected indent. Oh, there we go. Let's get rid of that one. That probably means I've made a mistake there as well. Okay, let's run that. Okay, so here we can see that Andy, Charlie, and Debbie have been printed because they have been set to true. If I want to look for other students who are not true, so the students who are false, I just reverse that option, that if statement, and I run it again. And this time it's going to print Bob and Eddie. And that's essentially it. That is how you print all the students who are true and all the students who are false. If I didn't want to search for those students, I just wanted to print them all, I just have to print name like so. Okay, and there they are. Now I'm lucky that the data is coming out in a sorted list here. A dictionary is unsorted by its nature, so you will need to apply the sorting rules. And again, I'll point you in the direction of this playlist. I'll put it in the comment, not in the comment, in the description below as well, so you can use that. But that's essentially it. So I hope you found that useful, and goodbye.